October meeting of the Caribou Mayor and Board of Alderman Board, call the roll, please.
Mr. Patrick Peglin.
Here.
Mr. Eric Jones.
Here.
Mr. Eric Smith.
Here.
Ms. Beth Lawson.
Here.
Mr. Dwayne Gibson.
Here.
Mr. Roy Nelson.
Here.
Mayor Stiksberry.
Here, we do have a quorum. Warren, would you ask our opening prayer for us, please, sir?
Dear Heavenly Father, we bow in your presence. We thank you for this day. We thank you for the many blessings of life. We thank you for the country that we have to live in, Lord, and go with us, lead, guide, direct, and protect each home that's represented here today. Watch over those that are sick and afflicted in body. Give the officials the wisdom to make the right decisions, Lord, for the betterment of the city. These favors we ask in your name. Amen.
All right, thank you, sir. All right, give everybody a few minutes, sir, to previous. Okay, everybody had a chance to look at the minutes. I hear a motion, we approve them as presented.
I'll make the motion, we approve the minutes as presented.
I'll second.
Discussion? All in favor say aye. Aye, motion carries. Citizens input. Anybody like to address the council? All right, communication from the mayor. Several things. I was, I guess everybody knows Hardee's is at 141 is open, and they are doing a pretty good business. Also, the dialysis center over here on the, up on Dogwood, they are, I believe, the city roof trusses. It was Friday, so they're moving right along with it, which is a good thing. Also, the ATV festival is this coming weekend. I encourage everyone to go to that, because that is helping all of us. I know it's a Follis festival, but there is a lot of people staying in our hotels, motels, that are going to that festival. And Chief, I think they're expecting a big crowd. Is that true, Eddie?
Well, I'm here.
Okay. They're expecting a big crowd, so a lot of
them.
How much?
Expecting 8,000.
8,000. Well, like I said, a lot of them won't be staying with us.
So I have spoken with several of the hotel owners and their management, and they said that they're booked.
Good. Like I said, it's good for everybody. So I encourage everybody, if you can go. I think they've got stuff for all ages, Eddie, kids, all the way through.
Yes. Okay.
If you don't ride ATVs, they've got other things to do. Okay. We met with well, y'all didn't know there was a campground going in up at 141. Part of that's going to be in the city down the road. Part of it will be. But we met with the owner Friday, just coming with the fire chief, just to look around and first one thing and another. And he's gonna have a top-notch, a top-notch place. He's very excited about it, and I believe we're gonna have a, I believe he's gonna have a very good thing. It's a, eventually, looks like it may be a very big thing eventually. But starting out, it's gonna be nice, but, that's also, you know, it's not, it's a part of it in the city, but still, it's gonna help us from the spinoffs. We're gonna have to buy the gas and eat, first one thing, no, it's gonna be, another one of those things gonna help everybody. The rec grant that we applied for, about, you know, doing the study for the recreation, I met with the folks first part of last month, back to this meeting. And, they are proceeding with that. Teresa gathered up some information for those folks, and they're going to be sending out, questionnaires to each household in Carroll to see what, his citizens would like to see as far as recreation goes. But, that's be, that's coming. So, just let everybody know, when we get that in the mail, that's what that is. One, on another good note, which, I mean, it's all good tonight, seems like, but now, I have got numerous phone calls, people walking up to me, talking about how nice it looks around the whole block. And, Eric Jones, he is the one responsible for that. He, that was his idea, and he's followed through with it. And, Eric, you have done a fantastic job of that.
Good job, Eric.
I said, I've had more people complain, you know, not complain, but compliment you on that. So, but it looks great. You've done a real fantastic job with that. Also, we finally tested our emergency siren, Friday, and it was a success. It works. That's a good thing. It took a little while to get everything together, but it, we did test it, and it does work, so.
Did they say, I mean, I know we're not probably discussing this, but did, has people said where they could hear it at around the city? Like, I could hear it at the school, but it wasn't real, like, I couldn't hear it inside, but I could hear it outside. So I didn't know, like around the city, what other people had said.
I think, Eddie?
From the graveyard, after on Ridge Road, we turned down to Prairie Smith, had a guy there. Shannon's Road, police officers in three different places over in the gap, back down here on Caramel Mountain. And like you, they can hear it outside, they can hear it inside here, but, you know, it heard.
Okay.
That's with the leaves on. And with the leaves off, probably hear it better.
Okay. Eric, did you have a lady that maybe called you from Scenic, I think Scenic Drive in Jacksboro, she heard it?
Yeah.
So, but I think a lot of people wasn't, it, what, you know, it rotates.
Right.
And, you know, it kind of comes and goes. When it rotates, that's when you hear it the most. But, it is up and functioning. All right, financial report, Ms. Teresa.
Our financial report in the general fund for the month of September totaled is $563,969.64. Reserve for special fire protection fees is $110,324.96. Reserve for rainy day fund, $45,000. The adjusted general fund balance is $408,644.68. And the State Street Aid Fund is $29,459.84. And the industrial fund is $868.89. And the drug fund is $12,655.16. So our revenue for the month of September was $142,324.75. And our expenditures was $123,658.32. With a difference of $18,666.43.
Okay.
And on your upper right hand corner, we paid two banknotes off. We had the sanitation truck, which was over $10,000, and then the police department was over $6,000 for the police vehicle. And so that's a total of $16,000. So with our bank notes and our revenue, we would have been $34,200.
Those are semi-annual payments, so they won't be back until what, March?
March and April.
So they're semi-annual, so that's the reason it was bound some with those two big payments. Do I hear a motion to approve the financial report as presented?
Make the motion. I'll second.
Any discussion? Call the roll, please.
Mr. Patrick Peglin?
Yes.
Mr. Eric Jones?
Yes.
Mr. Eric Smith?
Yes.
Ms. Beth Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Dwayne Gibson?
Yes.
Mr. Lloyd Lawson?
Yes.
Mayor Tixberry?
Yes, motion carries. Now, I didn't, we should be somewhere around 24-25%, and that's right where we're at. So we're right on schedule. All right, reports of council members, Mr. Lawson?
On the street sanitation, we picked up 46 tons of garbage, 3 tons of recycle, 4 tons of brush. Picked up brush throughout the city and matched potholes, fixed the shovel on Butter Bay, and rip-wrapped rock. Dug up chunks on Jazzburg Park, rock line, the ditch line on Mountain Road, Fall Creek Lane, and Cove Circle. Mowed throughout the city. And mowed the Jazzburg Park, and mowed some tiles out on Lake Lane and Cove Circle. One other thing, me and David talked today about our lights over here off the interstate. We're having a problem getting them fixed. He talked to the Copeland brothers, and they were real tickled to get our business, but they're kind of, you know, dragging their feet. I told David today, I said, you know, make sure if they want our business, tell them that we want these lights fixed. If not, we'll find somebody else.
Right, I know that one tall light on the
Yes.
on the northbound ramp is been out for a few days, and at least what?
There's one been out for about 3 weeks.
Okay. Well, anyway, they need
the other one got some bulbs out there. But anyway, he said he had to order a breaker, but he was supposed to came this morning. We called David and said he wouldn't be here till 11:30, and I talked to David about 2:30 to show it here. So I told David if he didn't show up, call him and see if he wanted to bend us on. Didn't last place.
I agree 100%.
Yep.
Well, that's it.
Okay. Blank?
Okay. Town Caravel monthly report for the month of September. We patrolled 8,709 miles. We had 24 citations. We had 228 complaints. We had 12 drug arrests. I'm sorry. We had 12 arrests. And out of those 12, there were 6 drug arrests. And we had 16 accidents. So we didn't have a whole lot going on for the month of September. That's it.
Thank you, sir. Beth?
Oh, under your report, we had 1,050 items checked out, 861 checked in, 388 e-books checked out. They added 13 new people and deleted 2. They had 263 computer users, loaned 2 items, borrowed 51, and the total library attendance was 444.
That's great. Still amazing. Our little library having that many people. It really does. That's great. Thank you, ma'am. Eric?
The fire department last month, we had one accident with injury. 3 men responded for roughly an hour. Vehicle accidents without injury had 2 of them, 6 men total for 2.5 hours. One brush fire, 5 men responded for an hour. One vehicle fire, correction, 2 vehicle fires, 4 men for an hour and a half. Two chemical spills for 6 men for 4 hours. Mutual aid was given 1 time, 2 men respond for an hour and a half. One tractor trailer fire, 1 guy respond for half an hour. 2 false alarms, 4 responded for an hour's time. Set up LZ for Livestar 4 times, total 19 men for 2 hours. Total 15 calls, roughly 99 and a half hours.
Thank you, sir. All right, I hear a motion to approve the departmental reports as given.
Motion made.
Second.
Discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. All right, any old business?
I'm going to do the website.
Okay.
Because we're a government entity, we'll be getting a .gov extension that's kind of standard. But we have to prove we're a government entity, so we're going to have to fill out some paperwork for that. I've been taking pictures. I'm kind of waiting on the leaves to change to take some more pictures. And Scott Fields is going to get us some drone footage, some overhead shots, and probably some overhead shot video to kind of an overview of Cove Lake area and just generally what we have going on. So that's where we're at on that. If we get the leaves changed, I can get some really good pictures for it.
Good. And this rain we had yesterday, that should help them really chime up.
I think so.
All right. Thank you, Pat. All right. Any other old business? Okay. New business. I would like to add one item to the agenda. I'd like to add item 5. I'd like to discuss the credit card limit for the city. Do I hear a motion that we add that to the agenda?
I'll make a motion that we add the
discussion by Mr. Tatum.
I'll sit.
Call roll, please.
Mr. Patrick Teedley?
Yes.
Mr. Eric Jones?
Yes.
Mr. Eric Smith?
Yes.
Ms. Beth Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Dwight Gibson?
Yes.
Mr. Lloyd Lawson?
Yes.
Mayor Stixon?
Yes. Motion carries. Thank y'all. All right. New business. Number 1, council to approve hiring Billy Lowe.
Yes. I'll make that recommendation. Billy is he's an A1 guy, and I've got several people that's bragged on him, and I'll make a motion that we hire Billy Lowe full-time.
Okay. Do I hear a second?
I'll second it.
Discussion? Call roll, please.
Mr. Patrick Teedley?
Yes.
Mr. Eric Jones?
Abstain.
Mr. Eric Smith?
Yes.
Ms. Beth Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Dwayne Gibson?
Yes.
Mr. Lloyd Lawson?
Yes.
Mayor Stixon?
Yes. Motion carries. Number 2, council to approve second reading of adopting ordinance number 2017-08, amending the annual operating budget FY17-18, which we did last month, is the bookkeeping on the budget. Do I hear a motion that we pass on second reading, ordinance 2017-08?
I'll make the motion to pass ordinance 17-08.
Second motion.
Discussion? Call roll, please.
Mr. Patrick Teedley?
Yes.
Mr. Eric Jones?
Yes.
Mr. Eric Smith?
Yes.
Ms. Beth Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Dwayne Gibson?
Yes.
Mr. Lloyd Lawson?
Yes.
Mayor Stixon?
Yes. Motion carries. All right. Number 3, discussion of iPads instead of paper. I think, Mr. Teedley, you was...
Yes, and I said this is something I would want to look at long term, like when we budget next year, we budget for this, if this is the route we decide to take. And that also gives us plenty of time to really look into it. But the school board, which is a 10-member board, they usually have some pretty big packets. They're still saving $15,000 a year by going basically paperless with the iPad. And I'm using the term iPad generically. It doesn't have to be an iPad. It can be any sort of tablet. And I also talked with Andy Wallace about it, who told me that Scott County has recently switched over their county commission to iPads, and they've not had them long enough to know how much the long-term saving is. But even has they even load it and get it preloaded with a set of government software that helps with stuff like budgeting, reports, basically all the stuff we do. And I said it's just a thought. If it can save us $10,000 a year budget wise, these things are pretty hard. If we decide to leave, we hand it off to the next council member. And I just wanted to get everybody's thoughts on that. And Teresa's provided us just what Computer Care can do. Basically, iPads are $349 each, but there's a another kind of tablet with a Lenovo ThinkPad that's got twice the memory and otherwise does basically the same stuff for $289. And that's without even looking into governmental contracts or anything like that. So like I said, it's the pleasure of the council, but I feel like if we can save either half what the school board saves, it's long-term worth it, both environmentally and budget.
I didn't know what this was about. I asked Dwayne when we first come in. But now that you mentioned it, I actually think it's a great idea. One, because it would be so much easier to, like, if we wanted to think, like, look back on something from last month, you could just, like, click on it and it would be there. Or if you wanted to look up, like, maybe her code things or something, all that stuff was electronically.
Right.
That would be wonderful.
And that's the sort of software, like, Andy was telling me about that Scott County has.
Yeah.
And I don't know that y'all that have been here longer than me. I got a stack of papers this tall and home I go through all the time.
Me too. And so, I don't wrote back because I keep everything, because I write notes on everything, so I keep it all. And I have a milk crate at the house that I keep all my stuff in just to look back on and think, well, when did we do this? I think it would be a great idea.
And like I said, I'm not saying let's make a budget amendment and do this now. Yeah. I'm saying let's look at it. Next budget cycle, if that's what the pleasure of the council is, we budget it, we buy it, we go pay, mostly paperless. There's some things I think that we're required to do paper on, but for the most part, it would be paperless.
Well, that's something that
I think it's a good
that's
idea.
Something we can definitely look at come budget time. Mm-hmm. And I said between now and then, we can research the state contract, what they are, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
That's something we can sure look at, you know, getting into.
Every school board member and former school board member I've talked to talks about how much easier it has made their life since they went paperless.
Plus, when the website gets done, it can be updated on that also. Like you see, you go back and look at prior meetings and whatever. So that would be something, and it's a good idea, but we'll definitely look at it.
I don't want to amend the budget. I think we got the budget, we're working in that this year. I just wanted to get the thoughts of the council.
Okay. I don't see where, I only see the advantages to it, but that's something we definitely look at.
Now, if that's what y'all want to do, I'm fine with it too.
It's
just an idea I wanted to present to everyone.
What? Money's probably in there at 40. Your operating supplies, that'll fall right in. You're actually going to deplete future supplies anyway.
Next week, I will go up to, I'll go up and see Andy, get in contact with the folks up in Scott County and see how much that software costs. Because I didn't want to delve too far into it. I didn't know what everybody wanted to do with that yet, but I know it's available. And the people that are using them swear by it. But I'm completely okay with it not being an iPad. I use the term iPad generic.
Right. But research a little bit more, Patrick. Get some numbers together, and we'll discuss it again next month. That's good for everybody. Get a little more information. We'll discuss it next month. Try and give us some more information, state contracts or whatever else. We'll definitely discuss. Sorry.
Include the department heads in.
I don't see why not. I think department heads should have one also. That way they'll be.
That'd be a good idea.
Yeah, good idea.
I'm strictly based. Almost everything I talked about on the school board, of course, they're a little bit different setup than us, but I think it will work very well with the department heads.
All right. Thank you, Patrick. Yeah, let's work on that. We'll bring it back next month, sir. All right, number four, discussion of sprinklers in commercial buildings. Mr. Smith or Chief?
Prefer most of Andy, but the question is, I guess, where we stand on as far as ordinances enforced with the businesses and having sprinkler systems. And that's, I think you and Andy may have spoken actually beforehand.
We have codes in place that covers that.
all of our commercial building, it's in a commercial building code. Anything over 5,000 square feet, new. If you're gonna do an addition, if it expands the fire area to 12,000 feet, square feet or more, it requires it. Different things kick it in to make it happen. The ordinances are there, but when you are dealing with smaller structures, smaller commercial structures, we don't have anything for that.
I guess that's the question. What do we need to do in order to put something in place? Now, size-wise, it is the issue, but I don't know if you've seen the pictures, it's been concerning.
I've been there.
But it's the fire load itself, what is possibly could burn inside that small structure.
Well, we can always go stricter than the code or the state law. We just can't go less than. But you also, you gotta be careful that you don't make it so hard that commercial businesses can't be there. And you got that.
Well, that, we're talking about a sprinkler system. A lot of times you're looking at insurance savings over.
Oh, I'm with you, I agree.
You really ain't gonna put a burden. You have to cost the front some bill a bit more, but your long-term, you actually make money off of it.
I totally agree.
But where do we stand is what we need to do in order to put some ordinance stricter in place from what's being required.
I think we need to work with Kathy and see what we can do as far as adopting or drafting stricter rules. It would have to be part of like a city ordinance, more so than a code. It wouldn't be a code, it would be an ordinance.
I don't think we can make it retroactive. It'd have to be from here on through.
Right. If you had a business change use and occupancy, then you could make them upgrade.
Right.
But if it would be like a restaurant for restaurant, you know, you're still the same use, same occupancy. And if they wanted to do an addition to it, then at that point we could start requiring different things.
We'll just get with Kathy and start drawing up something with Eddie on what he wants to see.
Yeah, I think it would have to be in the form of an ordinance, don't you think?
Now, when you say if they do an addition, would they just be required to do the sprinklers in the addition, or would that make it all of a sudden for the whole building? How does that work? Or do we know, is that more?
If I read the commercial code correctly, and I would have to get with my fire marshal and ask that I work with daily, if that structure is brought up 12,000 square feet or greater, then the entire structure would have to be sprinkled.
Okay, so they're no longer grandfathered, is that?
Right. When you start making big changes, you're grandfathered.
Gotcha.
So anything under 12,000 wouldn't require?
5,000 is the new structure.
Under what code?
The international code that we adopted. The ICC, it's the International Building Code. We're on the 2012 IBC for commercial.
So, Chief, could you get with Kathy and see what you two can come up with? Kathy, you work with Eddie, see what you can come up with, what we can do.
And you know, like our new dialysis center that's going up here, it wasn't sprinkled, it wasn't required to be sprinkled by the city until the plans went to the state, and the state made them because it's health, involved health. That's why it's been sprinkled.
So any health facility
it wasn't the state, has to be sprinkled.
Healthcare, daycares, assisted livings, anywhere where there's like assembly or occupancy.
So any building that's 5,000 square feet or bigger don't have to have it unless
there's a lot of things that kick it in that make it have to be, if we're building a daycare, it doesn't, it don't have to be 5,000 square feet to daycare.
Okay.
We're gonna build an assisted living. That has to be sprinkled. Schools.
Okay. Just we need to be clear on what we're agreeing to, because a lot of this stuff in the mix, they say, what's 6,000 square foot building? It's got to have it, no matter what it is.
If it's a new structure, it wouldn't have to be sprinkled.
Even though it's not a nursing home or normally daycare.
It depends on the type of construction.
If you have, there's like type one, type two, type three. It depends on what type of construction. I would have to see it on the plan when I sit here. The occupancy and the type, whether it's.
Well, that'd be something to be brought up here in planning commission too.
And it's also brought up to plans review.
Right.
Yes. When I do the plans review, I see the type of construction. And at that point, I can determine whether it needs to be sprinkled, and then they have to send it to State Fire Marshal.
And then the State Fire Marshal goes from there.
Gotcha. In the meantime, is, these pictures, what you're talking about is the congestion in the aisles. Is there something that we could do as a life safety issue?
That I can address, you know, up to a certain point, we're working on that, Kathy and I are. I can address that because means of egress on those pictures are blocked, and you can't block the means of egress.
Okay. But in the meantime, Chief, could you get Kathy, try to come up with a resolution to that? All right.
Y'all know this is not in the budget, right? You're adding something that's going to have to be added to the budget when it starts billing. This is not part of my flat fee contract, so I just want you, I don't care to do it, I just want you to be on notice that you're adding monies to, that you'll have to pay in the budget. And it's not budgeted this year.
Okay.
$2.50 an hour. It's my going rate.
Appreciate that, too.
Okay. All right. All right, number five, is the credit card limit. Discuss it. We are, right now, our credit card limit for the city is $2,500. And that is kind of low for a credit card limit. I'd like to hear some...
That's an abuse.
Well, you can, what I'm saying, if we use a credit card more, you can buy a lot of stuff on a credit card. It saves a lot, writing a lot of checks. And then a lot of times, if you order something with a credit card, they'll ship it right now versus, well, when we get the purchase order or whatever, we'll ship it. And it's a, it cut down on a lot of check writing. Plus, like I said, it's just up to the county, up to the council what y'all want to do. But I'm saying it's $2,500 now. I just want to see, would you all want to help it or not? It's a, it's totally your...
What is ordered? What do we order here over $2,500 at night?
Well, I'm just saying the limit's 25.
Period.
It's
period.
Not, excuse me, it's not changing the purchasing policy that's in place of who has to approve what and that type of thing. All of those limits are still in place.
Right.
This is something different what Bob's
saying. Yeah, it's just, this is just, you know...
Like, we wanted to expedite an order by paying via credit card rather than check, or if we wanted to pay our utilities on the credit card and then just cut one check at the end of the month. Does that make sense what I'm saying there? It not unlike the iPad discussion, it's kind of like cutting down the paper and such.
Well, so it's totally up to you. I'll just go out there and see what you all think.
Who's the user of this credit card more than anybody?
It would be the office.
Mostly the office, yes.
Well, how much money do you think you need on that part?
On that
part? Do you need 10,000?
Definitely, because when we pay our Visa bill, whenever we purchase anything, we like to use the Visa.
Would that be enough?
Mm-hmm, 10,000 would be enough. And we cut down the paper checks. And we cut down that, we just write Visa one check.
And you're going to stay in the IMAG, it makes bookkeeping a lot easier.
It does.
How much is it?
It's 2,500.
It's 2,500
right now.
Would you want to go 5,000 or 10,000?
It's up to you all. 10,000 preferably, but that's up to you all.
Would it be easier for you?
It would be easier at 10,000. It would.
And we're already set in place to pay the credit card every month, correct?
We do. Mm-hmm. We pay it every month.
So there's no interest accrued.
I'm on the motion to raise it up at $10,000.
I'll say.
Any more discussion, anyone?
Is that something you would put on the requisition instead of issuing a check, you'd pay by credit card?
Mm-hmm. Because of credit card more.
So that everybody would be, if you're signing a requisition or a PO,
still not changing the purchase order policy, we're just, instead of paying by check.
Just that you would show that you're paying it with credit card as opposed to check, so that if you sign five of them, you would know the three of them being paid that way or whatever.
And we do tend to get a merchandise basket.
That way you could designate it to show the council who you're ever signing those, which, how you're paying.
It'd be almost like writing a check, but just easier for the,
For the bookkeeper to keep more track of it, yeah.
We do that if it goes to the check, who the check goes to, or if they do it by purchase order, that's how we request money.
And of course, anything over $10,000, it doesn't matter, because we have to bid it.
Okay, we have a motion and second, any more discussion? Call the roll, please.
Mr. Patrick Peglin.
Yes.
Mr. Eric Jones.
Yes.
Mr. Eric Smith.
Yes.
Ms. Beth Lawson.
Yes.
Mr. Dwayne Gibson.
Yes.
Mr. Roy Lawson.
Yes.
Mayor Shakespeare.
Yes, motion carries, thank you. I'd like to call executive session with our attorney, a short executive session, please, for about 15, 20 minutes, and then we'll have the planning commission meeting. So, like y'all, if you don't mind the vacates, we have that, and then I will let y'all know we're going to planning commission.